Dahl's amazing world of imaginations has repeatedly enthralled both the young and the adult readers. All his novels are written in a way that they not only entertain but also convey a hidden moral value. The plots of The Witches, Big Friendly Giant, and Charlie and the Chocolate Factory all run on the lines of fantasy fiction that excite and engage the mind of the young readers. Similarly, Roald Dahl's Matilda is an important work of fiction, highlighting an exceptional childhood narrative through linguistic brilliance and vibrant illustrations. Matilda is written in a way that has moments of emotional excitement at every point, which makes it a must read. As promised in the last video, the link is in the description. Today, we will highlight the five parts of the story that develop a point of relativity between reality and fiction and in turn, incite interest in the young readers. The family. The initial portions of the narrative talk about Matilda and her family. Matilda here faces various kinds of struggles to cope up with her parents who have neglecting attitude towards her. Her parents are said to live in their own worlds of work and vanity, while Matilda immersed herself in reading books of all authors and all kinds, acquiring more and more knowledge. Matilda's parents remain unaware of Matilda's special learning capacity for a very long time. To take revenge on her parents, Matilda pulled off tricks and mischief on her parents. The kids like to live in their own worlds and explore new capacities, which they want to share with their families. But a neglecting family does not give them the space to express themselves freely. Thus, the young readers can relate their situations to these very real experiences of the fictional character Matilda. The children engage in this narrative to find out solutions to their unanswered questions. Let's see what happens next. The library. The library was an escape for Matilda from the dysfunctional family dynamics at home. She immersed herself into an extensive reading. Within a very small time span of 6 months, Matilda had read a plethora of different books of various authors and genres. Isn't that amazing? But Matilda kept on exploring and widening her learning capacity and had finished reading all the books in the library. This part of the story introduces to us the exceptional capacities of this fictional character and thus also encourages the children to emulate this healthy habit of reading. The school. Matilda's school structure was created to take a dig on the reality of the education system. At school, Matilda befriends her teacher, Jennifer Honey, who is the first teacher to recognize her extraordinary capacities and is astonished by her intellectual abilities. She tries to move her into a higher class but is refused by the headmistress, the tyrannical Miss Agatha Trunchbull. Miss Honey also tries to talk to Mr. and Mrs. Wormwood about their daughter's intelligence, but they just ignore her. This is a reflection of the education system which fails to identify the real capacities of children and only focuses on a routine learning technique. Miss Honey is the only source of assurance for Matilda. This character seems to have been created for the children to relate it with that one teacher or one person in their circle who trusts their capabilities, however absurd they might be. The backstory of the character also appeals to the adult readers who understand a more complex family dynamic. Isn't it a character that children will relate to and love? Similarly, magic has been used in the narrative and is introduced when Matilda uses an unexpected power of telekinesis to tip a glass of water containing the newt onto Miss Trunchbull. The children enjoy this potion as it directly appeals to their imagination. Matilda practices this extensively and masters the power. This is the most exciting part of the narrative and thus glues the young readers till the end of it. At this point, the plot has two sides, Miss Trunchbull and Matilda, assisted by Miss Honey. Based on the age-old theory of hero and villain, that makes the story automatically more entertaining for the young readers. These plot elements, assisted by Quentin Blake's illustrations, make this a very special story for all ages. Dahl's simple but impactful language furthers the message, thus making it a very important part of English literary world. Did you enjoy this video? Then what are you waiting for? Go grab the book and read it with your young readers. If you like our video, do not forget to share it with your friends, comment and subscribe to our channel. We will be back with more interesting videos. Till then, happy reading!